is also known as the Scream.
It is in a glass and it's melting.
It is one large spherical orb.
The glass is larger than average. It's a little bit dented.
It is perched precariously on the windowsill.
It's one of many plot devices in this glass.
And this is fancy hand carved ice.
It's cold.
It's slowly melting in an ounce of whiskey.
You can see there's a handprint on the glass. There is a red lipstick stain on the glass.
This glass has been refilled with whiskey without being washed in between several times.
This glass has mild smudges and cracks, but not so much to discourage a person from drinking.
You are a fine form, nice piece of glass.
You are well loved.
You are last call.
You are what someone is coming home to.
You used to be freezing.
You have a story for your friend last night.
You're the friend I need right now.
You're what welcomes me home at night.
You're gonna help me get a drink. Valot, mildly incriminating evidence.
Thou art comforting.
Thou art what gets me through the day.
Thou art liquid courage.
Thou art the heart of an evening, a midnight, and a morning.
Thou art a hot summer's respite.
Thou have use 24 hours a day.
Thou hast gotten me many a cold night.
Thou art the equivalent of a sexy lady.
Thou hast more years left in you.
Thou allowest me not to think about the kids right now.
Thou art just the right temperature.
Thou art my wonderfully cold distraction.
I am warm and comforting despite my cold exterior.
I am what saves you when the air conditioning is broken.
I am deluded but powerful.
I am the reminder you need that life can be okay if not great.
I am clearly out of your league.
I am not dead yet.
I am ice!
You know, Bob, down here in these mines, I'll tell you, I'm really dreaming of my girl back home.
Thanks, Charlie. You know I'm new here. I'm scared of working down here, but I see your veteran Steely Hands over there, and I know I can just get through this first week on the job.
That's right. You just gotta keep calm, let your hands grow the calluses they will, and, and just think about all the things you have back home. Maybe it's a girl, maybe it's an antique fish tank.
Oh, that's right. I think about my antique fish tank all the time. I've been here only one day. I already missed that tank.
I think that's the only reason any of us are mining in the first place, because antique fish tanks have so much insurance to pay for.
You too, huh? Oh, Charlie, yeah. My insurance expired. My antique fish tank. I knew I needed to take this second job and sign up here to work in the mines.
You know, I think it's just terrible what they do to hard-working guys like us who come home every day and just want to sit in the glow of their antique fish tank, but have to pay so much insurance because what if it cracks? And what if the fish fall out?
It's a nightmare, Chuck. It's a nightmare.
I'll wake up in these mines every night screaming. The man asked, what you screaming about there, Roy? I say, fish, eels, and squids everywhere. And then I get back to work.
Hey, Roy, guys, could you sign this card for Tim? His tank cracked the other day. He didn't have insurance.
I thought the kids would never get to bed.
I thought the same.
You did a great job at the PTA meeting tonight, dear. You did a great job. The teacher was completely on board with the ideas we had for Jennifer's education.
My thought is if you show them the error of their ways, they get it.
I hope you're not.
They're confused, but they'll get it.
Yeah, we just need to guide them along. You know, they're learning too, even though they're the teachers.
Charlene's education is a lifelong project.
Cheers to us, Roger.
Oh my god, the Woodford Reserve?
Is it that kind of a night?
It is a good night.
Finally, the kids are to bed. We've taken care of their education for now.
The fifth grade comes soon, but you know, for now we're
done
our bit.
Yeah. So you know, at this rate, maybe she'll skip a couple of grades and she'll be in fifth grade before we know it.
Shirley's not gonna have this conversation again. She needs to be at the same level as her peers, okay? Social things are as important as academic things.
Raj, what if her peers are in the fifth grade? Her soul is older.
Which at least it's okay if her soul is older. It's just Harvard looks at more than GPA, okay? She has to develop as a person as well. She needs to take some time to mature before the SATs, before the applications go in, all right? That's my only point, you know that?
SATs. That's a great idea. We could do SAT prep all summer.
PSAT. Remember, PSAT, SAT, Harvard, Yale Law.
Yes. Just like us.
Cheers.
So, you want to be a matchmaker?
Well, yeah, that's why I'm here.
Well, what makes you qualified?
Well, I set up my roommate with
okay, I see
my
that.
Best friend, and they're,
sure.
You know, they're engaged.
All right. Well,
so I list the best references.
Yeah, but I see that you recently broke up with your boyfriend of 3 years.
That's a mark.
That's
a hit.
We actually talked about that.
Because I just think, you know, it's been rough. You know that we've been grooming you for years to be the best matchmaker you can be. But you need to love yourself first, okay?
All right?
We can tell that you've been a little down.
Well, yeah, we were together for so long and didn't work out. It's disappointing.
So I've just been trying to do some personal growth stuff. Okay.
Is that what you're calling it?
Personal growth.
All right.
Well, people have noticed that you have been a little bit awkward and uncomfortable in the office. If that's what personal growth is for you, great. We'd love you to start sharing that. Okay, Denise?
Okay.
Well, I lived with my boyfriend, and now I'm staying at a hostel because I can't. If you guys don't,
I saw you in your car. It's okay.
Okay,
you can stay with me, all right?
I can?
You can stay with me.
Really?
It's okay. I've invested a lot in you, and I can't lose it now, so.
Okay, this is such a relief. I actually have my car packed up, just because I was, like, in between places.
Great, well.
So, cool, so I can just move in.
Sure, roomie.
All right. So.
Hey, everybody.
Hey!
Hi.
Hey!
Hey!
Oh, hi! So, fish tank manufacturers are getting some complaints about the quality of our fish tanks.
Mm-hmm.
Do something about that.
That's goddamn wrong.
Smells like some bullshit.
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 Well, Steve, we're getting some complaints. We have customers that are losing their tanks.
You ask me now, and yet 7 months ago I came to your office and said the epoxy that we're using is not the ideal epoxy. You said, thanks for your input, but no thanks at the time, and now you're coming to me to take your chestnuts out of the fire, so... I don't want to crow.
Guys, before we turn on each other, the problem here is clearly that the public doesn't know what they want. Our fish tanks are perfect.
I think it's the faulty epoxy, actually.
Okay, maybe it's the fish, alright? Yeah. No one's gonna say it, but maybe it's the fish.
I actually think it's inhumane to have, like, fish tanks anyway.
What if, instead of glass, we just diamonds? Just crush up diamonds and make that into glass.
Will they crack it all?
It's uncrackable. It's indestructible.
So you know a more economical option would be to keep glass, which is quite cheap. Epoxy, higher quality.
An even more economical, suggestion would be to maybe like let the fish free. Or how about we just kill all the fish? Because when you get them at a fair, they only are going to live like a day anyway. So
we should
just.
Maybe sort of destroying our target market.
Tanks since my grandfather founded this company in 1843. We don't need to change that, fish or no fish.
I would say, technology has advanced. We're at a level of epoxies that's almost unfathomable.
This is real.
What about
diamond necklaces to anchor the fish?
That sounds awful.
It sounds fabulous. I would kill for a diamond necklace.
It's just like something you could have, but it has nothing to do with the fish tank.
Well, it's not like the earnings that we've seen this quarter, man.
Yeah, let's just take all the money and run. Sorry. You know what, Sheriff? I've been working as a cop for a long, long time. It really gets me going. Like, keeps me going when I just think about my son. And I'm fighting these streets to keep him safe from a boy.
I hear you there, Deputy. These are some mean streets. People smashing windows, smashing cars.
It's terrible. It's terrible out there. So I'm going to go out of here real quick. You got to keep something to keep you going. Like, I got my boy. You could think of anything to keep you going. Like, maybe an old piece of paper that was written by Abraham Lincoln. Some people, that is their thing,
I would lose my mind if I didn't have my aid paper. This is excellent coffee, by the way. It calms my nerves when I think about what if the paper had been assassinated alongside the president.
Oh my God, a tragedy that would be.
Hey, give me your fucking wallet.
Whoa!
Right.
Not the left pocket!
No,
Box,
not my
ink
paper!
This is...
I don't carry my gun on me.
Well, that's... Do you know how Abraham Lincoln died? He was unarmed and he got shot in a theater.
I never knew that. I always assumed that it's something to do with aliens.
Well, there have been theories. Here in Arizona, I can't just shoot the guy for stealing a piece of paper. So I had to let him go.
I guess I'm gonna go crazy then.
It's alright, you can take
Don't
my...
Don't me.
This is Thomas Jefferson wrote this. It says, "Dear, pick up the eggs."
Oh, thank you. And
I'll give it to you.
You can take my George Washington tooth.
Oh, wow! is this made out of wood?
I think so.
Wow.
Hey, this is a stick-up! Let me get all your historical artifacts! Come on, let's go.
Christian myth. And it's just really immature of them to still believe and Professor, I know my midterm is late, so I just wanted to turn in my English 101 paper.
Yeah, I don't think anybody actually believes
it. Oh, everyone seemed really upset when I was talking. And I'm sorry I disturbed class, but they needed to know the truth.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm glad you thought that maybe just
read it. Having a lot of trouble relating to my peers.
Yes.
Like, nobody ever invites me to parties or to play that pong game.
You here as a 10-year-old,
here
at Harvard, it's really, you know, you could consider maybe going back in a year.
What? Do you know how hard I've worked to get to this place?
I know, you've blown everybody away with all of your work, man.
Good right there. Hey, Brock, here's my poem. Let's be playing Bad Old Lady. You want to come along?
Hey. I have an old spirit soul. I do. That's what I've been told my whole life.
I know, but you know, you're only like 4 feet tall.
That doesn't count. Gerald's 4 feet tall, too.
Gerald has a beard and
I can't grow a beard.
Yeah, can I just stay out of this, please?
Fair.
Know what's going on in the world anymore.
People say it died along with vaudeville, but it's more alive than ever here.
Too bad we can't actually synchronize.
That's why we practice, Joanne.
Just saying, you guys, we don't really have the chance right now.
Resurrecting a lost art is not the work of a week, okay?
Wait, oh, she think the sound effects are necessary?
According to the records, that's the most important part.
We're synchronized. We both all have, like, no, we're not. Hey, you. Hey, Sokash, on. That's not what that means.
Wait, it's not about the swimsuits?
I'm here for the swimsuits.
The sound
shoes? I'm here for the sound effects.
So we're all agreed, we're here for the swimsuits and sound effects. My options here for you. It looks like you're 27, healthy, 7 or 8 years of experience with various fish, both salt water and fresh water. So I'm willing to offer you a package, $1,500 a month. It seems like a lot first, okay? But can I just tell you, there has been a rash of tank explosions. There's nothing anybody can do. There's no preventative measures you can take. All you can do is prepare yourself and your family.
Nothing anyone can do, huh? You know, I hear that there's nothing anyone can do about exploding fish tanks. You know, my grandpa's company has been doing something about that for years. You see, most people make the mistake of filling their fish tanks with water. You should fill them with dirt. Because dirt doesn't explode. I'll take my money, please.
I want a discount on my insurance.
You want a discount?
Yeah.
I'll see what we can do. Let me just
phone calls.
Hello.
Yes. No, fish tanks aren't made of water. They're made of other things.
Discount badly. Want to give it to him. He's like, what? Yes, okay, good. $1,488. $1,488 per month. Can I just say? I just have to my wife.
Well, my grandpa has been working on alternate technologies for storing fish in tanks.
I've been hearing this a lot recently. Grandpa's.
So my tank exploded, and I have a piece of it in my neck. I would like my money back, please. I'm like dying here, man.
This against your neck here. Dying.
Yeah.
You know what? This is just for future record, for future reference. 911. Your neck is bleeding.
Yeah, but
like a week later.
But my money. I need my money, man.
See, here is that you filled it with water. And I clearly wrote in the instructions not to do that. They paid me a very good salary.
Oh my god. You know, I was reading about those like diamond encrusted tanks. I don't think that would have happened with one of those fancy tanks. Ooh, I am not feeling good.
I am the spirit animal of this very mature 10-year-old.
Okay, I'll write your paper for you, but you gotta get me, a little bit of Coke. I'm gonna get an invite to the frat party on Friday, and I want you to take my driver's test for me.
Also, we need some crushed medication.
Last time he's old. All right, it can happen, but you can't tell a soul. If anybody finds out that I'm dealing to a 10-year-old, I'm done. These lips are sealed, lady. Okay. Alright. So it's a term paper? I'm having trouble. You're the same age as my little sister.
Yeah, but I'm 10 times smarter than you.
I can't argue with that. Very for sure.
That's why she gets a spur now.
Yeah. Where's your spur now? That's right. You don't have one.
Honey, is that oxycodone? Why, I didn't start doing oxycodone until I was 13! You're so embarrassed.
Are these your parents?
Cheer
party tonight.
Yes. Okay, I'll have your paper to you by Friday. Hello, professor? It's medicinal.